Hey, welcome back, everyone. My name is Prestige. This is Prestige Q&A Sunday. Every single Sunday, we'll be doing a Q&A all the way up to 1 million subscribers. And guys, I got to just thank you one more time. The amount of support that this channel has been seeing over the past couple of weeks has been absolutely staggering. In the past week, we've gained over 15,000 new subscribers. One of those days, we gained just 7,000 in one day, which is absolutely crazy. We're going to be hitting a million subscribers soon, so I might continue this series every Sunday, but if it's something that you want to see go away, just let me know down below in the comment section. The gameplay you're going to be watching is absolutely phenomenal. We went ahead and dropped a 90-plus game right here on Fringe, rotated through those wraiths and the wraps like crazy, and overall, it's just a great gameplay. So I hope you guys can do the same. Share your support down below by clicking that thumbs up button. But let's start with the first question that isn't necessarily on this list, and that is, what is that camouflage that you're using on the CUDA? I got that question a lot yesterday in my video where I was using it, and people don't know it. I didn't originally know it. It's called Nuketown. You get it from a GameStop pre-order bonus when the game originally launched, and unfortunately, you cannot find this code anymore unless you go to eBay, but I don't know how trustworthy that is. But that's the unfortunate part. You cannot really get this anywhere as of right now. GameStop doesn't have them, and it wasn't really publicized. It wasn't put out there, so I didn't even know about it until after the game launched, and luckily enough, I had a couple of followers that worked at GameStop, and they were able to hook me up with a couple codes, not only for me, but also for my fans over on Twitter. So that's pretty cool. Let's get into the questions over on Twitter, starting with Sotiris asking, if you could bring a multiplayer map from past CODs to Black Ops 3, which one would it be? Now, I'm thinking that if any map I would bring, honestly, I wouldn't want any old maps brought to the new Black Ops 3, but if I had to choose, I would probably say Raid from Black Ops 2. That map was just awesome. I expect it to come back. I expected to see a return. It was a fan favorite map, and I honestly loved it a lot too. I can't wait to see if there's going to be like a map like that in the future where we can just call in our wraps and stuff and they roll around in that little middle area. I don't know. I'd like to see that a lot. Raid is one of those maps that I would like to see come back. Now we got the next question from Lewis asking, do you fear a life without gaming? Honestly, no, because if there wasn't gaming, I'm sure that I would have something else to preoccupy my time. Next up, we have the White Kid asking, which COD studio is your favorite, Treyarch, Sledgehammer, or Infinity Ward? Treyarch, hands down, just because they've been an established studio there for such a long time. Infinity Ward recently moved, so their studio isn't set up all the way, and Sledgehammer Games, it's really nice, it's wide open, and they got a lot of developers doing a lot of things, but Treyarch just has a lot of nostalgic things all over the place. Painted walls, just interesting awards, and just everything you could think of right there as soon as you enter in, and I just like it overall because of the nostalgia factor that is there. Next up, we have a question from Eros asking, which do you like better, core or hardcore, and why? Now, this is a really good question, and I'm going to take a minute to answer it, but I prefer hardcore in Treyarch games. As weird as that sounds, I've always felt that way. I've always played hardcore in Treyarch games, and I recently found it again here in Black Ops 3, and I came to love it. I played a lot of core with the initial launch of this game, but after seeing that domination was changed, after seeing that it just feels similar to what World at War was in hardcore, and the fact that I can do really good in hardcore, it makes me feel a lot better. The only downside to this is when I upload videos, I see a lot of people actually say, oh, why do you play hardcore? Why don't you play core? Hardcore's easy mode and blah, blah, blah. And honestly, there's a lot of give or take with both modes. Core mode, yes, it takes more bullets to kill your enemies, but you're also regenerating your health. And you also know that if you're not completely on your target or if you have bad accuracy or whatever, you might die or you might get the first shot and you still end up dying. And that's a really annoying thing for me. I don't like it. Maybe my accuracy isn't the best, but if I can still kill somebody by getting the first shot in hardcore, then that's where it is. But in hardcore, you also have to remember you can die in one shot. You can get killed in one bullet. And if you do get shot and you don't die, it was from wall penetration and your health doesn't regenerate. There's a lot of give or take, and there's a lot of reasons why I think core might be a little bit more interesting, or core might be a little bit more skill proof, as to where I think that hardcore might be a little bit more skill proof. There's just a bunch of different reasons why, and that's just my quick explanation of it. All right, next up we have Zach asking, are you ever going to try the 70 kills in TDM challenge? I didn't even know that was a challenge, but I'm sure one day I might come across it. I don't think I'll ever be able to do it. Wyatt asks, who were your role models growing up? Honestly, I didn't really have any. As bad as that sounds, I didn't really have any role models because everything that was going on in my life was just really poopy. My dad wasn't really there for me, and it was just, it was bad. So growing up, I didn't really have any role models, and I just kind of stuck to myself, and I did what I needed to do in order to make my life the way it is now. So I'm pretty proud of myself, I guess, but otherwise, I really didn't have anyone to look up to. All right, next up, we have Eden asking, what's your favorite Call of Duty and why? World at War, because of World War II, and just right around the time that I started playing it, that's what we were learning about in school, and I just thought it was so fascinating, so being able to do that was pretty interesting. Now, I know that World War II is such a bad time, and everything about it is terrible, but just the history behind it is really what makes me love that game. All right, next up, we have Singles asking, which COD do you want to see remastered the most? And that kind of falls back on the other question, which was my favorite COD, and I would like to see World at War remastered. Just because of all the semi-automatic weapons, I loved the rifles, I loved the snipers, I loved the pistols, I loved the sounds. Everything about it is just my perfect game. That's pretty much it, and I would love to see it remastered in all of its glory. All right, next question comes from Joseph, and he's asking, what keeps you motivated to make videos every single day? I was wondering because I need a little motivation. Honestly, it's like having that goal. Like, you need to have a goal. And if you have a goal and you set that goal and you want to accomplish that goal, you feel so much better about yourself. So just me uploading every day, keeping me motivated, knowing that I'm going to make a ton of people happy when they see a new video go live, knowing that I'm going to be able to interact with a ton of people, that's kind of what keeps me motivated. Plus, I just love YouTube, and I love uploading to YouTube, so that's kind of what keeps me motivated as well. Having a goal and being able to interact with people and knowing that I'm going to be making people happy, those are the three things that really motivates me here on YouTube. All right, next question comes from Zachary asking, are you excited for the next Doom game? Absolutely. I am so stoked for the multiplayer. I can't wait for it to come out. And I really want this to be the perfect Doom game that we never had. Doom is a perfect game, hands down, by the way. But I'm just saying, like, I want this to be a very good experience. I want it to be as gruesome as it looks in the trailers. I want it to be brutal. That's what Doom is all about. It's always about breaking boundaries. And I think that's exactly what's going to happen with this one this year. All right, Silver asks, if you had one chance of developing a game, what type of game would it be? And this is just such an in-depth question that I wouldn't even know where to begin. It'd probably take some years of planning, and I just need to have an idea, but I don't know if I would want it to be a shooter. I'd probably want it to be like a puzzle platformer, or maybe some sort of horror game. I'm just not sure yet. I haven't decided on something like that because I've never really crossed my mind, but that's a good question, dude. All right, next question comes from Steve. Do you like Black Ops 3 matchmaking at the moment? I really haven't had an issue with it. All right, let's go ahead and take the final question from Vexilite asking, what do you think COD 2016 on last gen will be like? Honestly, it's probably not going to be on last gen. I don't think that they're going to develop for Xbox 360 and PS3. We've seen how bad Black Ops 3 looks, and I don't think with the technology going further and further every single year, that we would even be able to see a last gen version. And if that's the case, I feel bad for everybody that's still stuck on last gen. But then again, we're going on 4 years or 3 years now of having the Xbox One and the PS4. So it isn't necessarily a bad thing to be putting those consoles in the past. Even Microsoft said in 2016 there wouldn't be support for last gen, or there wouldn't be as many games coming out for last gen. So that's what I think. I really hope you guys enjoyed this Q&A today. I hope you enjoyed the gameplay. If you did, make sure to click that like button down below. Don't forget to subscribe for more awesome videos each and every day. And until next time, I am out.
Peace.
Oh, hey there, thank you so much for joining me at the end of the video. If you missed yesterday's videos, I'll have annotations up on the screen right now. You can click on those. If you happen to be on mobile devices, make sure to check the links down below in the description. And until tomorrow, I'll see ya. Peace.